निष्ठा प्रेमी. आई एम नॉट अलाउडिंग यू टू ऑफ योर वीडियो. स्टार्ट विद योर वीडियो. यू हैव टू स्टार्ट द क्लास विद योर कैमरा विद योर वीडियो ऑन. ओके अदरवाइज आई एम गोइंग टू रिमूव यू फ्रॉम माई क्लास. Otherwise, I'm going to remove you from my class. Ayush Yadav, are you listening to me? Aditya Chauhan also. अक्षिता आयुषी अक्षित खंडेलवाल. अक्षित गुनी बंसल. बेटा आप इन अ मिनट I will remove the those students who are not listening to this teacher. ठीक है? You have to be in my class. Will start your camera, okay? Now. Okay, students. How are you? Now yesterday we were discussing about the literary sources. The literary sources, most of the manuscript were written in particular which languages? Okay. The what do you mean by the manuscript? The manuscripts are the old books or documents written by the hand only. Okay. सिर्फ हाथ से ही लिखे जाते थे hand written documents and hand written books. These books or documents are called manuscripts. Clear? And these manuscripts were written in Prakrit, Pali, Sanskrit, and Tamil. Okay? All these languages are the medium of expression. It belongs. From some reasons, people are used to speak the Prakrit language. Some people are used to speak the Pali language. Some Sanskrit and some were Tamil. Okay, clear? And as we can see, Mahabharata and Ramayana were written also in Sanskrit language. And you people are very well aware about these two epics. And some of you had seen that series. ड्यूरिंग द लॉकडाउन आपने लॉकडाउन के ड्यूरेशन में सीरीज देखी भी होगी आपके डीडी नेशनल चैनल पे देखी थी जस्ट गिव मी द थंब हां हैव यू एंजॉयड दैट ओके वर रिटन इन संस्कृत दीज वर रिटन इन संस्कृत दे वर रिटन इन नॉर्थ इंडिया वेयर संस्कृत वॉज द मेन लैंग्वेज इन नॉर्थ इंडिया द संस्कृत वॉज द मेन लैंग्वेज हाउएवर मनी मैकालाई Mani Makkalai and the Silapadi Karam were written in the Tamil as they were written in South India. Okay, just because in South India the Tamil was in practice, the people were used to speak in Tamil language. Clear? Over the years, most of the manuscripts had got destroyed, but many of them are still preserved in temples, monasteries, libraries, and archives. Here, the reason they were not kept carefully, but many of the manuscript were kept carefully in the some temples hain, some of in the monasteries hain, but this monasteries like and some of in the libraries and archives also. The library sources can be divided into religious and non-religious or secular literature. Here, up. religious literature, we can divide the literature in three forms: religious literature, secular literature mainly. Theek hai, religious and secular. Now religious was just like we have to give the example of Ramayana and Mahabharata here. Religious literature, the literature which was written for spreading religious teachings and rituals, come under this category. The particular king, a particular follower, they wants to spread the ideology and they wants to spread the religious teachings and the rituals of their particular religion, so that the many of this manuscript written in written according to their religious thoughts. ठीक है, तो many, there are many religious literature. The four Vedas, as you know, you can ask your parents also. There are four Vedas are the oldest religious Sanskrit texts of Hindus, which contains prayers, stories, rituals belong to the Hinduism. ठीक है, and you besides them there are many Upanishads also. Many Upanishads है, Smritis है, Brahmanas है, Angas है, Apangas है, Purnas, Mahabharat, Ramayan, Jatak tales etc. Many of you have the Jatak story tales with you. Your parents what you for reading these interesting stories. Are also religious literature. Some old religious books of Jains were written in Prakrit language. It's you have to mention that point also. Many of the Jain religious book they were written in the Prakrit language, and many of the Buddhist texts were written in the Pali language. There is the confusion between the student. Kuch student confused ho jate hain ki Prakrit language or Pali language. You have to mention that Prakrit language followed by the Jainis and the Pali language followed by the Buddhist mostly. The literature of South India written in Tamil, mainly jo South Indian literature hai wo Tamil mein likha gaya, aur Telugu also. The people were used to speak the Telugu and the Tamil language. So religious literature, and there are many religious literature like Quran. It is written in the Arabic language, and Bible. आप बहुत सारे यहाँ पर example आप समझ सकते हैं, set कर सकते हैं. You can mention the example like your own for only understanding. Clear? कि जो डिफरेंट रिलीजियस लिटरेचर है दे आर रिटन इन द डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस एंड द पर्टिकुलर पर्पस. व्हाट वाज द पर्टिकुलर पर्पस ऑफ दीज लिटरेचर लैंग्वेजेस फॉर स्प्रेडिंग द रिलीजियस टीचिंग्स. दे वांट टू स्प्रेड द रिलीजियस टीचिंग्स एंड द रिचुअल्स कम अंडर द दिस पर्टिकुलर कैटेगरी हियर. नाउ सेक्युलर, you people are very aware about that particular word secular. That literature secular, if we are talking to about the secular literature, we are talking about the secular literature. It mean it contains no religion, non religious nature. The purpose is the non religious nature. There are many many important literature parts pieces in the form of poetry, plays, stories, travel accounts, ethics, and these are non religious in nature, so that we call them secular literature. Clear? This is general literature which includes poetry, plays, stories, traveling accounts, and ethics. They are of non religious nature. Okay, most of them most of these things are written in to record the events and rules of the society and administrative regulation. Many of the rulers they want that people will know, people will be aware about their administration, their reason, their wars, there was so that many of the books written for that purposes theek hai the books like dharma shastras theek hai kautilya's arthashastra who wrote the arthashastra give me the message arthashastra kisne likhi hai who wrote arthashastra kautilya yes kautilya upranshu very good that was kautilya and kalidas abhijan shakuntalam the author of the abhijan shakuntalam was kalidas theek hai bilkul isi tarike se panchatantra panchatantra it is also very famous and I also fond of that book also aap logo mein se bhi bahut sare logo ke paas bahut sare bachcho ke paas ye panchatantra ka book hogi very interesting stories written by the vishnu sharma these kind of books are categorized as a secular literature these books are not belong to any particular religion here so you have to learn these authors and the written material and the books belong to them okay in south india agar hum south india ki baat kare sila pandi kram and the mani maglai are not only delightful to read but also tell us about their society these are two books in south india these books are belong to south india and these and south indian books are written in tamil and telugu language yaha jo hai it is very delightful to read and by from these book we can know about the society which kind of society they belong to kis tarike ki society thi unki livings unki occupation etc any other things now the accounts of the foreign travelers like Indica by the Greek ambassador Megasthenes in the court of Chandragupta Maurya written of Chinese traveler Fang Yi and the Huang Sen who visited India ab हमारे जो इंडिया में देयर वर मेनी फॉरेन ट्रैवलर डू विजिटेड इंडिया आर आल्सो सेकुलर ठीक है यहाँ वी हैव टू मेंशन द नेम ऑफ द बुक फा हाइंग बुक वाज फा एग्जाम एंड द हैंग सैंग बुक वाज सैंग जेंग क्लियर द मेनी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स रिटन बाय दीज ट्रैवलर्स for about our country about the rulers of our country about the people of our country about the culture of our country about the eating habits about our wealth many other things clear okay now as we can see who visited India during the Chandragupta Maurya's period okay you have to mention the name Megasthenes theek hai they describe the political social and economic life of that period they also describe unhone kya hamara economic political and social life theek hai so hamari society mein kis tarike ke administration ya fir bole ki the administrative of the particular belong to that particular ruler the manner how the people the occupation they followed the society values they followed what kind of culture the India followed clear now Fa Heng gave a detailed account of the reason of Chandragupta Vikramaditya while Hong Song wrote Syaki which is an important source of information about king harsha theek hai you have to mention these two example and you just underline that particular thing ki who gives the information about which ruler kisne kis ruler ke regarding mainly information thee. Okay. Now, besides them, there are many Roman and Greek accounts that tell us about ancient India's geography and trade. बहुत सारे रोमन और ग्रीक अकाउंट्स भी हमें मिलते हैं. विजिटर्स यहाँ आए. दैट इज द नेम ऑफ सियाकी, मीन दैट इज द नेम ऑफ अ बुक बेटा. ठीक है, दैट इज द नेम ऑफ अ बुक रिटन बाय योंगसेन. ठीक है, नाउ रोमन एंड ग्रीक अकाउंट टेल अस अबाउट एंशियंट इंडियन जियोग्राफी ट्रेड एंड पेरिप्लस ऑफ द एरिथ्रियन सी इन अनदर account of a Greek traveler who described the various part of India as he traveled from the Mediterranean Sea to the west coast of India. Clear? Now we have to mention all the examples also, like Greek account. यहाँ पर Greeks का आप example आप डालेंगे जिन्होंने जो Mediterranean Sea से यहाँ आए, Western India में travel एंट्री करी, वेरी दे ट्रेवल वेरियस पार्ट ऑफ द इंडिया एंड गिव द इम्पॉर्टेंट इंफॉर्मेशन टू द वर्ल्ड फॉर द इन अकाउंट ऑफ इंडिया. क्लियर? मैनी सेक्युलर लिटरेचर वॉज देर देयर. वहां पर बहुत सारे सेक्युलर बुक्स के यहाँ नाम है एंड द राइटर्स ऑफ दीज पर्टिकुलर बुक्स एंड ट्रेवलर्स ऑफ एंड हु ट्रेवल ड्यूरिंग ड्यूरिंग विच पर्टिकुलर टाइम पीरियड. The accounts of some kings were written as the biographies by the writers of their court. पहले टाइम में क्या होता था, there were many kings who have the personalized writers, जिनके personal writers होते थे and they wrote about their king, their administration, their rule, their wars and for then phrasing them. They were actually phrasing the dam in their book. Now, Banabhatta, if we are talking about these kind of example, hum agar is tarike ka example agar hum dekhe bache, to Banabhatta was a writer in the court of Harshvardhan who wrote Harshcharitra. Theek hai, Harshcharitra kisne likhi? Banabhatta ne. And to whom it is regarding, किसके regarding है ये हर्षचरित्र? हर्षवर्धन के regarding. There are many more accounts of king are there in recent. Clear? Who wrote Banabhatta? नहीं, the writer was Banabhatta and he wrote हर्षचरित्र. Just underline that also. So by the religious literature we can know about many facts. The religious literature, the non-religious literature, we can say that secular literature also. Clear? Now kya ki by that if I am going to unmute a student for reading that and underlining the main point, whenever I will tell you, jab bhi main aapko bataungi, just underline that particular word. Aditya Kumar. Aditya, are you ready to read? Aditya, you want to read the literature part? Okay, very good, Aditya. Hanji Aditya. Yes, Aditya. Just start with the topic religious literature. Other student, you just keep quiet, listen carefully.
The literature this was has written for sparing religion, teaching and ritual comes in under the category. The four Vedas are the oldest religions and faith texts of Hindus, which contain prayers, stories and rituals. Beside them, the Upanishads is simply the Brahmas, Ansas and the Apsaras, Purayanas, Mahabharat, Ramayana, Jataka, etc. are religious literature. The old religious books of Jains were written in Prakrit language and the Buddhist texts were written by the Impalani language. The literature of South India is facilities in Tamil and Telugu language.
ठीक है, we had completed the religious literature. There, you have to mention the main literature belong to the particular religion, just like Ramayana and Mahabharata and some of the name of the Upanishads, etc. And you have to mention the from that paragraph you have to mention the language followed by the Jains. The books of Jains were written in Prakrit language, and the books, the Buddhist texts were written in Pali language. Here in South India, the Tamil and Telugu language, the important language was Tamil and Telugu. Yes, Upranshu, just I am giving you the chance. Okay, Upranshu, I am going to unmute you. Okay. Hanji, Upranshu, just continue with the
secular wala putna hai na.
Yes, bachi, secular.
Secular literature. This is general literature which includes poetry, plays, stories, travel accounts, and ethics. They are of non-religious nature. Most of them are written to record the events and rules of the society and administrative regulations. The book like Dharma Shastra, Kautilya, Arthashastra, Kalidas, Abhijan, Shakuntalam.
Jan Shakuntalam. Continue, continue. Very good.
Vishnu Sharma, Panch Tantra, etc. Belong to this category. In the South India, Silipakadram and Mani Mikali are not only delightful to read but also tell us about their societies. The accounts, yes, of the
from these paragraph, just from the first paragraph, there is a meaning of secular literature. Okay, you can got the meaning of secular literature. Which kind of literature we can say that these are secular literature. Just these are non, these kind of literature are non-religious in nature. Clear? They are non-religious in nature. They are not belong to any particular religion. Now next paragraph, there are many important books belong to our Indian culture and their authors. Clear? Like Dharma Shastra, Arth Shastra, the writer was Kautilya, Abhijan Shakuntalam, it was written by the Kalidas, and the Panchatantra, it was written by the Vishnu Sharma. And two important books belong to the South India. You have to mention these points also. Clear? Now continue.
The accounts of the foreign travelers like Indica by the Greek ambassador Megasthenes in the court of Chandragupta Maurya, writings of Chinese traveler Fa Hexin and Hilian Song. Who visited India are also secular literature. They describe the political, social and economic life of that period. Fa Hilin gave a detailed account of the region of Chandragupta, Vikramaditya, while Vijayan Sang wrote Saikui, which is an important source of information about King Harsha.
Yes. From that paragraph, you just underline the Greek ambassador's name, Megasthenes, who visited the court of the Chandragupta Maurya, and writings of Chinese travelers also. The name of the Chinese traveler, there were two names, Wang Hang and Hong Song. The written material written by the Fa Song and the Hong Song, it was Don Zong. Okay, they were also visited India, and these type of books are we can include in the secular literature. Okay, they had told us political nature of our country, social economic life of our country, a particular of that period also. Fa Hong gave detailed about the Chandragupta Vikramaditya. Okay, jabki Hong Song ने क्या बताया, सो कोई रिटेन जो कि हर्ष किंग हर्षवर्धन उनके रिगार्डिंग दे गिविंग द इंपॉर्टेंट अकाउंट. क्लियर? नाउ कंटिन्यू विद अनदर पैराग्राफ, अनदर स्टूडेंट. आई एम गिविंग यस अनदर वन. अक्षित खंडेलवाल. यस अक्षित. हां जी अक्षित, कंटिन्यू. अक्षित खंडेलवाल, Akshit, continue with another paragraph. Akshit, what happened to you? You had raised the hand. Akshit, what is the problem now? Shaurya Mittal.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Shaurya Mittal.
Besides them, there are many Roman and Greek accounts that tell us about ancient Indians' geography and trade. The Peripals of the Erythraean Sea is another account by a Greek traveler who describes the various parts of India as he traveled from the Mediterranean Sea to the western coast of India. The accounts of some kings were written as their biographies by the writers of their courts.
ठीक है. नाउ मेनी ऑफ द ट्रैवलर विजिटेड इंडिया, द वेस्टर्न कोस्ट ऑफ द इंडिया फ्रॉम द मेडिटेरेनियन सी. ठीक है, दे आल्सो गिव अस द इंपॉर्टेंट इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द इंडिया. एक्चुअली द रिटन मटेरियल रिटन बाय देम, जो भी उन्होंने लिखा है उनके थ्रू, दैट वाज द इंपॉर्टेंट लिटरेचर व्हिच वी got from by them, written by them, कि हम उस टाइम में जान सकते हैं कि that from that particular area कि किस तरीके के rituals, religious activities, social activities and the cultural activities were followed by the people of the India, that particular region. And many of the king have the biographies and written by the person who their court person, जो कि उनके court में होते थे, writers उनके court में होते थे, they accountable details for these rulers. Yes, continue.
Bhanavad was a writer in the court of Harshvardhana who wrote Harshacharita. There are many more accounts of kings and their regions. Timeline: historians arrange the events of history in sequence as per the time when they took place. This is called timeline. Since history deals with the past of human life, it is important that each event is linked to a fixed point of time on a suitable scale. Time in history is studied in the form of BC and AD.
ठीक है. Now सबसे पहले तो हम we have to mention the example of Bhanavad. ठीक है. Bhanavad was the writer belonged to the court of Harshvardhana. ठीक है, एंड ही रोट हर्षचरित. नाउ टाइमलाइंस, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, टाइमलाइन. नाउ 2 मिनट्स आर लेफ्ट. इफ एनीबॉडी वांट्स टू आस्क, यू हैड ऑलरेडी आस्क सम ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम, सम ऑफ द क्वेरीज, बट इफ यू वांट एनीथिंग, यू वांट टू आस्क एनीथिंग, यू कैन आस्क. ओनली रेज योर हैंड इफ देयर इज एनी प्रॉब्लम, यू कैन रेज योर हैंड, देन आई विल अनम्यूट यू दैट पर्टिकुलर स्टूडेंट. ओके
मैम.
यस बेटा, हाँ बोलो
मैम. कल आप, मैं रिपीट करोगे मैम इधर से ही
फ्रॉम द टाइमलाइन.
ओके मैम.
the chapter will be completed tomorrow. Okay, कल ये chapter complete हो जाएगा.
मैम ग्रीक का मीनिंग क्या होता है?
किसका?
ग्रीक.
The name, that is the name of our area. ठीक है? ग्रीक. ठीक है? Now, anything else? शौर्य मित्तल, yes बेटा बोलो.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you want to ask anything?
No, ma'am.
Okay, Akshit Khandelwal. Yes, Akshit. If there is a problem, Akshit. Bolo, Akshit. Speak up, beta. Akshit, what do you want to ask?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. So why no, ma'am. Why you are raising your hand?
Ma'am, galti se ma'am lag gaya.
गलती से हो गया.
Yes, ma'am.
Is everything clear to you? सब कुछ क्लियर है?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good, Akshit. Okay. And anybody wants to ask anything?
No, ma'am.